Hello guys, as you can see, we begin our video today with Buddy on his bed. We have the conch bowl, we have a piece of bread, we have ate breakfast. This bread is from yesterday, but as you can see, we will play with our food as usual. The bed is smaller than the dog. Buddy, what are you doing? Buddy, buddy. We're talking. Give me a moment. Sorry guys, I just had an incoming call. And in the meantime, as you see, Buddy is sleeping again in his favorite spot. Buddy! I'm here, but don't bother me. Okay. Let's see when we have stopped. As you can see, we have placed some pieces all over the deck. I strongly believe that the pieces, or some of the pieces, are out of scale. The pumps are very big. Also the wheel, and this thing, I believe it's called capstan wheel, maybe it's not, it's in the wrong position. There's no way over here that it can be turned around. It's definitely wrong position, definitely. Don't know why they put it there. Okay. We have some pieces to place, of course, here at the empty space, and somewhere here it's going to be placed a wrench. And this wrench is going to be hard to be made. It's like the wrench that the Beagle had on and the Bounty had on. It's similar, and it's a very hard piece to make. But let's see now. I see the photos. I have to make a chimney, and this ain't easy either. So let me cut my materials and I'll get back to you to continue. Here's the piece. This is 6x6, and what I see here, I must mark the edge at 14 millimeters, and I will show you how to work with. Sorry for that. First, let's mark the 14 millimeters. Give me a moment. I need to sharpen my pencil a little. 14 millimeters. This is it. All right. In every side. I have marked everything. Now we're going to the other side at the edge, and I have to make it from each side 1 millimeter to the inside. You will understand exactly what I'm telling. Let's turn this so it will be more easy for me to work. So we have 6 millimeters, and we mark at 1 and 5 on each side, of course. We mark 1, 5. Now let's draw some lines. What's the most easiest way to do it for me and for you to watch? I'm going to do one in the camera and the other ones on my own. Okay. Each side the same way, and then I'm going to sand it down to leave, to trim out all the exterior and leave only the inside, to have it like a cone. So let me do that and I'll get back to you. Got it. Now let's cut it exactly over here. Got the piece. This is the base. What we need now is another piece that it's rounded. Let me find out which one and I'll get back to you. This is going to be tricky. This is 4 millimeters. Now we have to make a diagonal cut. It's going to be a little bit tricky, but if I manage to do it correctly, I will have exactly what I need. So let's find out. The piece at one side must be 6 millimeters. Let's try this way. 6 millimeters is over here, but on the opposite side, which is, let me mark it, I'm not able to see it. So the opposite side, it's over here, must be 2.5. 2.5. This is going to be hard. So I have to cut it like this. Let me do that. Got the piece, as you can see. And now, because I have a clean cut, if I put it like that, I have a perfect 90 degrees angle. That was the secret. Now the next piece must be 7 millimeters. I will find out the 7 only by one edge, and I'm ready. don't mix them together. This is a 6, this is a 7. So what I see now, the 6 must go like that over here. So let's glue it. It absorbs so fast that I'm not able to glue it. It's unbelievable. I will try it anyway. What I need to do now is trim it a little here to make it as round as I can, so this will be able to fit perfectly. This will take some time, so let me do that. Got it. Let me give you a closer look. It's perfect. Now I'm going to glue the other part like this. The angle is perfect because these two were once one piece, so I will have a perfect angle of 90 degrees and a perfect fit. I will do that. I will trim them a little. I will glue the base. The base is prefixed. Okay, I have to pass it somehow, probably with a little sanding. That's not a problem. I will have to paint them because the chimney doesn't look good like that. It should be metal. Photos tell me to paint it red. I'm not. I'm going to paint it black. So let me do that. Let me finish it and I'll get back to you to continue. Ready. The paint is drying, of course. So we have to wait a bit to be able to glue it. So give me a moment, some moments of course, for the paint to dry, and I'll get back to you to glue it on the deck and continue. So guys, I've gathered up the materials that we need for the next piece, and I'm here to construct it. This is 5x5, I have cut it in the specific length. The other pieces are preformed, and this is one is metal. This is the bell tower. I'm going to need also a bell, but this bell tower will be painted because I don't believe that the metal with the wood joins together. It will be a little bit ugly, so I will paint it. Don't like that, but I will do. First of all, we have to construct it. So we have this piece. This is the main part of the bell tower, the centerpiece, and we have to glue this over here like that. Of course, if the glue is absorbed by the wood, you won't get any glued action. Come on. Why? This is plain wood. Why? Not varnish, not anything. Plain, simple wood. don't get it. Right, I believe I have it. Sent it and all the stuff. Now, here on the top and in between these two, I must put this one. Of course, I have to close the gap. So let's see how it will work on the one end. Now let's work the other end. The pieces seems to be fitted perfectly, but as you can see, this is not the actual thing. Come on! Give me a moment to let the glue dry. Done, also placed the metallic piece. Now I have to put these two pieces right here, right about there, just a little bit lower than the edge of these two pieces, right here. I have to drill a small hole about 2 millimeters wide and 2 or 3 millimeters deep, not more, and I will insert the pieces. Let me drill the hole and I'll get back to you. I have a 2 millimeter hole. Now I'll take the right piece, as I see in the photos, and put it inside. Take the left piece, you can see there's a curve here. Put it inside, twist it, make them flat. Okay, this one is also this one. Let's put some glue. And we're ready to paint it. So give me some moment to paint it black, red, sorry, When I paint it, I will put here the bell, and I'll get back to you to continue. While waiting for the paint to dry, let's work on a couple of more pieces. Here we have a piece that must be formed into a square. It has some cuts on, so it's easy to be bent. Got a very small square. Tells me not to glue it. I won't. Leave it like this. To tell me not to glue it, probably there's a reason. Now this. This is a little bit strange. Cut it also, and this is going to be attached over here at the two tiny cuts we have. They're very visible, but okay, got it. Wasn't so hard. And I have this piece. Yeah. Now I'm going to glue it though. To glue it, I need to be able to have the glue flow through the tube. I'm going to leave it here a while for the glue to dry. After all, it's metallic. And let's see, the paint is dry. Almost, just a few bits, but I am able to touch it. Here we have the bell. Underneath the bell, I have placed a nail. Above the bell, I have the nail coming out about 1.5 millimeters. This is something that I am going to do. You're not required to do that with the nail, that is. I'm going to try to make a small hole. Let's see if I can touch it. Okay, I can touch it. No, it's impossible to do the hole. It's impossible. Should have made the hole prior. So the nail won't help. Let's see if I can remove it. Easy job. I will leave that over there. It's like having a complete bell, so seems to me it's better Let's put some glue here. And see how we're going to attach the bell. Hopefully it will stay there. Leave it. Give me a moment. Now we're going to do some more work, just a little bit. I'm not going to attach the bell tower in position yet because it's going to be attached with the wrench. So this will remain over here for a while. These pieces are definitely from the wrench, definitely. I have some more pieces here. These are going to be attached like that. I must trim it so I will make it fit. I must use this piece on the other side and everything is going to be painted red. Let me do that because it's going to take a while and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And got them. The paint is not completely dried yet. As you can see, it still dries. But these are the two first pieces of the wrench, the side ones. There's a lot of work to build the wrench, believe me, and it will take a while, but we will complete that in our next video. So guys, remember that you have the Super Thanks ability in each and every video. You can use it whatever you want. You can Super Thank Buddy for all his effort. You can see here, Buddy! 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 Okay, we're stretching. Okay, and start whining again. You can super thank that. Thank you very much, guys, for watching. See you soon.